Welcome to Make Web Better. Today, we're going to learn how to create HubSpot payment form using Stripe with FormPay. Okay, before I start collecting payments, I need to decide on the payment method. Now, let me guide you through the payment methods that FormPay supports. We support payment collection through HubSpot forms and payment links that you can create via deals or contacts. If you're looking to collect payments through contacts or deals directly from HubSpot, please check out the other videos on the playlist, or you can click the info card icon to find the video playlist. So yeah, for those who want to collect payments through forms, let me begin by creating a HubSpot form instantly and guiding you. So let's create a form right now. It can be a simple, basic form. You can use any form template, and within it, we can add any fields or details that HubSpot supports, and FormPay will seamlessly support them. For instance, you can include contact properties, company properties, and ticket properties. Feel free to add as many as you need. You can also make fields dynamic, and that will work perfectly. Now if I update it, and I can name this like FormPay, or like Course Payment Form. And after it is done, we just leave it as it is. And now you're able to see that this is a form and it's published. Now, if I return to the FormPay dashboard and navigate to the Forms section, you'll notice that it's currently empty. So I will proceed to create a new form. This action will generate a new FormPay form that will be linked to your HubSpot form. The interface you're seeing here is what we refer to as the Form Editor, because it offers a wide range of functionalities. At this stage, you have various configurations to explore. By default, the test mode is enabled. If you wish to collect payments in live mode, you can disable this option. While in test mode, I have these four gateways available, and in live mode, I've enabled Stripe, which is now visible. So with this enabled, let me name this form Course Payment Form, FormPay. Now you'll have the option to choose a HubSpot form. I've just created this HubSpot form called Course Payment Form. You can simply select the one you want to collect payments from right here. And these are donation settings. I'm not recording this video for donations. I will record another video for that, so kindly ignoring it now. Coupons, I will also discuss about coupons in next section. And this is the section. What will visitors see after submitting your form? So you can redirect the user to another page. You can have your own page where you can show some congratulations, thank you for the purchase, different things that could be your total custom page or any other page. By default, there's a thank you page that appears after the payment. You can adjust these settings to fit your needs. I'm not making changes right now. As for the payment amount, it's straightforward. So for example, my course is for $999. So I can add 999, and the currency would be the currency that was selected in the gateway. So if I select, for example, Stripe over here, it would give me this thing that you can select payment gateways with one currency type, because yes, we want the user to have one currency type on one form for now. Later on, we might see that, we might explore that, but okay. I selected Stripe, and now this is selected default gateway. You can ignore this functionality for now. Let me guide you around this later on. Later videos. And if you don't want to collect subscription, just ignore the setting and publish form. If you publish the form, it would say the success form updated successfully, and this form would show up. If you notice, this form is exactly like the HubSpot form that was made, and in fact, we are using HubSpot only to render this form. So all of the fields that are going to come are coming from HubSpot. And if you make any changes in this section right now, first name, last name, email, and phone number is coming up. For example, if I add in street address and update it again and publish it, it would update the form directly, so you don't have to come back again. Create a new form. It would just update the form directly. So I relive the page, and now I think the street address should show up. Okay, now the street address is showing up. You can open this directly on a page. This is like a link that you can copy or share with someone to test it or also make payments. So for example, if a customer wants to take, you are dealing with a customer and you want just him to pay, You can share this link, but I don't recommend it because it's like using FormPay as the domain, so I can fill in the credentials and different things. So this is showing up from the Stripe, and we are showing the Stripe card options. You can also modify this from your Stripe section. You can just select what wallets you want to take payment from. For example, want to collect Google Pay and Apple Pay and link transfers through Stripe. So in that case, you have to enable those things in Stripe. That would automatically show up in this section. So it's using payment intent functionality from Stripe. If you are aware of it otherwise, you can ignore this for now, and the customer can do the payment from carts. Now coming back to this section, there is this EMD code option as well. If you click on EMD code, and it says that this is like the script, you can copy and paste it to whatever page you want to take payments from. So it can be a HubSpot page, CMS page, WordPress page, any HTML page. Just copy the script wherever you want to show, and the form will show up. Okay, now in the next section, we'll see how we can collect the payment and see it in HubSpot using FormPay. Thanks for watching. Feel free to drop a comment if you have any questions or need further clarification about any part of this video. Also, remember to show your support by liking, sharing, and subscribing. I'll catch you in the next video.